In this video, we're going to be showing you how to paint the techno-archaeologist Daedalosus. And to do so, we're going to be using the classic method and we're going to paint the miniature up to battle ready. To do this, as with any Citadel miniature, the first thing that you need to do is to undercoat your model. And for this one, we recommend Mechanica Standard Grey Spray, which you can see is what I've sprayed my miniature with just here, because this is a really good starting point for all the colours that we're going to be using. The first base paint that we need is lead belcher to paint all the silver metal details in the miniature, and because there's quite a few of these, I'm going to be using a medium base brush to apply this. Now what you need to do is just get some of this paint onto your palette like this and add a touch of water to thin it down so it's nice and smooth, mix it together like that, and then just make sure that your brush isn't overloaded. And by doing this, what you'll find is that your paint goes further and dries smoother, and later on will give you much more control over it as well. So once you've done that, all you got to do is start looking around your miniature to find all the silver details. And actually with this first step, you don't have to worry at all about being neat. Just make sure you catch all the parts that are going to be silver, and if you catch any other details, well, don't worry about it, because we are going to be painting further base paints over that later on. For example, on the robes just there. Once you've finished base coating those silver details, we're ready to move on to applying some more base colours to the miniature to add a lot more colour to it. And first of all, we're going to be applying some Mephiston Red to all those red robes, and then we're going to move on to Corvus Black for all the black details across the miniature. After that, we need a small amount of Retributor Armour to pick out some gold metal details, and then an even smaller amount of Corax White. This is going to be for the white details on the Cog Mechanicum symbols. With that done, we then need dry bark, and this is to base coat all the brown leather details. But first of all, we need Mephiston Red, which I'm going to be applying using a medium layer brush. And now we need to be a little bit more careful about where we're applying this paint, because now we need to start painting around that silver detail that we've done. So as before, I'm going to use the palette to get the paint ready, but this time you can see once I've thinned it down, I'm just going to twist the brush like that, dragging it along to get rid of the excess paint and to bring the bristles to a nice point, because now we have much more control over where it's going. What we're aiming to do here is to base coat in all the red robes, so things such as the hood round here. And you can see what I mean about the silver details, because we've got this little stud that's poking through the hood there. I'm just going to be really careful going around that there like that. Now if you do make any mistakes, don't worry about it, because you can always neaten up that silver at this stage, but for now you just need to concentrate on painting all the red robes. Now when you apply this colour, if you see some of that grey showing through, don't worry about it, just let the first coat dry and apply a second thin coat in exactly the same way. Next up, we need Corvus Black for all the black details, such as the tabard down here, all the cables and pipes, and a few of the details scattered around the miniature. There are quite a few of them, but as I said, you're also looking for things such as the cables, such as the one just here and the one round here. Also, we need to paint this collar that's going around his neck, so this is the area down here, being careful of that silver, and also the red when you get near to it. We need to paint the gloves, and also at this stage, be sure to paint the entire Cog Mechanicum, and that is this skull symbol with the cog running around it. We're now ready to use Retributor Armour to base coat all the gold detail, and a lot of this tends to be quite small, so we recommend using a small layer brush for this and just really taking your time picking it out, being as neat as you can. Now also at this stage you want to pick out the raised texture on the tabard down here, and for this actually it's a good idea to often use the side of your brush and just lightly graze it across the texture like this, because this way you just catch the raised area and get a nice neat straight line. With all that gold picked out, we're now ready to move on to applying some Corax White. And first of all, we need to apply this to the Cog Mechanicum. Now for this, we've got the cog half on the left being white. So what you need to do is just be very neat, picking out the raised texture of this detail like this, going around to about halfway there like that. Then on the skull, you're doing the other half. So start out in the middle by just painting vertically like that and fill out the rest of the skull. Now you can see this is very fine detail. If you make any mistakes here, just neaten it with Corvus Black before you continue. There's one other detail to pick out at this stage, and that is on his shoulder up here. We've got a small white disc, so be sure to base coat this in as well. And finally, use dried bark to pick out all the leather details around the belt. With all those large areas of colour now base coated in, we're ready to move on to base coating some of the smaller details in the miniature. And first of all, we're going to be using Wraithbone to base coat all the skin, followed by Avalanche Sunset for some of the cables. After this, we need Caliban Green to base coat all the data screens, and then finally we need a little bit of Thousand Suns Blue, and this will be for the glow on the gun and also some of the buttons. But first of all, we need Wraithbone, which I'm going to be applying using my small layer brush, because this detail is very small now, so you don't need very much of this. But as before, make sure the paint is nice and thin, so it's flowing smoothly. There we go, you want to bring it down to about that consistency there. And then what we need to do here is, of course, base coat his face, of which you can't really see very much, so you just need to be really neat as you start painting in around here. But also, he is wearing a fingerless glove on this side, so you need to be sure to base coat his fingers and thumb as well. Next, we can move on to Avalanche Sunset to base coat all the smooth cables around the miniature. For example, this one up here on the servo arm. Then with Caliban Green, we can base coat the data screen down here along with one or two of the buttons. And finally, using Thousand Suns Blue, we're ready to paint the coils and the gun. And really what we're talking about here is the recesses along here. So just running the blue into the recesses of this black casing we've got like that. Also, we need to pick out any bionic eye lenses. So just really carefully, a spot of blue in the middle of these areas like that. And also finally, paint in any remaining buttons. And there we are, with all the base colours applied, we can now move on to applying the shade paints to the miniature to really give it some depth. And for this, we need three different shades. First of all, we're going to use Norn Oil for all the silver details, followed by Reichland Flesh Shade for all the skin. Finally, we're going to need Agrax Earth Shade, and this is to shade everything else on the miniature. But first of all, we need Norn Oil, and I'm going to be applying this with a medium layer brush because we want to keep this focused, as I said, just onto those silver details. So whilst you don't have to use the palette to thin the paint down with any water, it is useful to make sure that your brush isn't overloaded. You don't need too much of this at once. So once you've got the right amount onto your brush, all you've got to do is start looking for all those silver details in the miniature and applying this colour straight over them like this so that the paint runs into the recessed details and gives you that definition. Next, apply a small amount of Reichland Flesh Shade over the skin, and for this we recommend using a small layer brush. And once that's dry, apply Agrax Earth Shade using your medium layer brush across all the remaining details. Once that shade is dry, we're then ready to apply some texture to the base. And for this, the texture paint we're going to use is Astro Granite. Now to apply this, what you need to do is get hold of one of the texture tools, and to use it, you just use a shovel side to get a good scoop of the paint like this, and then look for an open space on the base. So usually the front of it is a good place. What you do is just put that dollop of paint on there carefully like that, and then use the tool to start spreading it around the base, switching to the narrower side when you get close to the miniature so you have a little bit more control. Now once you apply this all across the top of the base, it'll take around about an hour to dry, and once it is dry, all you need to do is paint the rim of the base, and for this miniature I'm going to use a Baden Black. Once you've done that, the model is battle ready. And with the texture paint completely dry and the rim of the base painted, Daedalosus the Techno-Archaeologist is battle ready. So when you're painting this miniature, there's a few key things to remember. The first is that when you're applying the base colours, there's a lot of fine detail, so be sure to really take your time here, being as neat as you can. Also, be sure to pick an appropriate sized brush for the area that you're painting. Especially on this miniature, you'll find that a small layer brush and a medium layer brush are incredibly useful, so bear that in mind even when you're shading the miniature. But really, that's all you need to know, so we really hope you have fun painting this model, and we'll see you all again very soon.